ठीक है।
सॉन्ग
अपना मैम यू कैन ओके
या
या कैन वी स्टार्ट अश्विनी, इट्स 4 o'clock।
या या एब्सोल्युटली।
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड अ वार्म वेलकम फ्रॉम कॉलेज ऑफ होम साइंस निर्मला निकेतन अफिलिएटेड टू यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मुंबई। आई मिस अश्विनी चौहान टेक प्राइड इन होस्टिंग दिस नेशनल वेबिनार ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय Community Resource Management Department. It is rightly said that the art of drawing without an eraser and creative thinking inspires ideas. Here we are today to start with our webinar on creative arts mixed media organized by Community Resource Management Department. I kindly request Ms. Rupa ma'am to please introduce our speaker. And before that, I request Sunita Jaiswal, ma'am, the head of our department, to please address our participants.
Good evening and warm welcome to our principal, ma'am, Dr. Geeta Ibrahim, my dear participants, and the expert of today's webinar, Ms. Aparna Seth, who is highly creative in her artwork, which we have already seen in our previous webinar. It gives us immense pleasure to welcome you all in today's webinar on mixed media workshop. I know you all are going to enjoy it very much. College of Home Science, Nirmala Niketan, the only home science college affiliated to University of Mumbai, stands for its academic excellence, whereby young women are equipped to meet successfully the challenges of family life as well as those from the professional world of this changing modern India. The BSc in Home Science, specializing in community resource management, is designed to impart advanced knowledge and skill that is life-oriented, career-oriented, and community-oriented. We can proudly say that the department is associated with Pidilite since last 4 years, and they have conducted wonderful workshops with the FYBSC students as part of their curriculum, Aesthetics and Interior Design. The department also has special relevance to all industries, small scale as well as large manufacturing units, processing units, because of its various subjects in curriculum like man-machine interaction, hotel application, interior design and decor, tourism and hospitality industry, occupational health, and management of specific resources. In last 35 years, the department has seen various milestones. The department is run by 3 faculty members, Ms. Rupa Rao, Ms. Sakina Chhatriwala, and myself, Ms. Sunita Jaiswal. I now welcome you all in today's most very creative webinar, and I hope, and not hope, I'm sure you're going to enjoy it very much. Welcome all. Thank you.
You have to unmute yourself, Ashwini. Ashwini, unmute yourself.
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am, for those kind words. Now, I please request a faculty member, Ms. Rupa, ma'am, to please introduce our speaker to all the participants.
Good evening, everyone. And I don't think so. Aparna ma'am requires any more introduction after the one-stroke workshop that we had or live. There's so many people asking, can we get her contact number? Does she take classes? So you're just getting too famous, ma'am. Aparna Seth, ma'am, is a senior certified professional artist. And she's been conducting classes, and she's affiliated with art classes, hobby classes, as well as her passion for painting since the last 30 years. She's working with the Pidilite Industries as a creative faculty since the last 23 years. She's also worked with Camel Private Limited before getting affiliated or before joining the Pidilite Industries. She conducts various workshops on art, not only at her home by running personal classes, but also, I'm sure, just like Nirmala Niketan invites her, she gets invited to many, many schools, colleges for her classes. And I've always told her since the time I've met her for the decoupage workshop that she's got magic fingers. And I'm repeating it again. So here we have the lady with magic fingers for us to teach us what we can do with all sorts of waste and mixed media art. Welcome, ma'am, and over to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. Hello, everyone. Good evening. I hope everyone is ready with the material. First, I would like to thank Rupa ma'am, Smita ma'am, Sakina ma'am, and all team members of your college students. Warm welcome. I'm again ready with my new topic, that is mixed media. Here, we are going to use all household things which we are just throwing it away. We are not using. Sometimes we feel it is not at all useful. But now you will see the imaginary. You can imagine which things we can use, all possible things we can use in mixed media. The name is such. Mixed media means there is a wonderful, wonderful mixture of all different types of artwork. Of course, it's a visual art. You can imagine your own concept. You can just think about anything and you can present it on either on canvas. Again, here we are going, we can use different various material on various background. Say, for example, wood, you can use it on, you can do it on glass, you can do it on acrylic sheet, you can do it on plastic, you can do it on tin, any chocolate dabbas which we are going to use it today. So there is, you know, n number of variations and possibility to decorate with the mixed media. So I'm really very eager to start today's session. I will be like what things we are going to use it for this particular art form. First, I will show you. You won't imagine what things I have gathered. Since morning, I was literally searching for all old piece of laces, old flowers, if you are having pom-poms, if you are having buttons, old keys which are already rusted, no problem, not at all. You can use, and then I had this stones, quite long time, I think so, before 15 years, I was having fish tank at my place. So I had this small stone. First, I thought of throwing. Then I thought I will do something out of this also. So I had this. Then I'm having few beads. Everything mixed, embroidery things we are having at home, like beads or stones or pulses that I'm having. And then we can use, of course, our colors will come. And here is the, which today I'm going to show you, this chocolate dabbas. Usually we throw it one, we had one article on decoupage, we did it on this. So I'm having this tins with me. So later on you can see. First, I would like to show you, because later on as we start, I should not forget to show you my article. This is the thing which I already posted. And it is on your poster also. So it was color box and it is plastic box. So with this effect, you cannot make out whether it is plastic or metal, but this is normal plastic, my color box. And I just covered, you can see so many things. I stuck it on top of that. This all old things, beads, stones, buttons, then keys, whatever was available that time. I just stuck it and I made this article. Then one more I will be showing you. Why I'm showing you this? Like if you are having bottle or box or canvas, whatever. See here on bottle I have done. So you can see the old sharpener. We are just throwing if it is not working. So I think so now you know when we'll throw it. Because you can see this is the lace piece, old one. It was not even half meter, not even quarter meter. So very small piece. So I thought what to do, but I just kept it. And I used it for this. Then you can see all old nails. I was having few molded flowers with me. I usually, whenever like my leftover molded is there, I always make small flowers and keep as it is. So somewhere if you want to make emergency mein kuch aisa article banana hai, so I do use that. So I have used screws, you can see the nails, different size of nails. So this kind of things we can use it. One more.
Can you get the bottle closer to the camera? Because we couldn't see the nails.
Yeah.
Okay, see, ma'am.
So both the sides I have done.
Yes.
Here I have just applied glue, and these are all nails, screws, nut bolts, almost old sharpener. Without like it was not using, and here also I have done one. So sometimes I can keep my bottle like this. Sometimes I can keep like this.
Lovely.
Thank you. So it is visible. Yeah, yes, same.
Thank you.
I have used, you can see this box. It was, sweet box. So I have done different textures on this, which I'm going to show you today. Okay. So these things, then I will give the close up of this also.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. So the thing is, like, we can, there are n number of things we can create on the top, and we can make our normal ordinary box or whatever article you are making, it will become extraordinary. One more thing I would like to teach you in this, which I really, I'm really happy to share that is, the image transfer. So we are not going to do only this thing. Like, of course, reverse image transfer I'm not going to teach because it takes 24 hours to dry. So normal image transferring I will be showing you with mixed media. So you will love to do that. And usually people are doing on canvas board, but we will be doing on the box. Okay. So let's start. Then one more thing I would like to show you, that is, if you are having the old keychains, the attachments, what we are getting. So same kind of things, if you are having, you can definitely use this pieces also. If you are having this kind of flowers, that also you can use it, which we are going to use it. So then again, today, like, I know I have planted so many things. I don't know the box. I think so the place will be lesser for me. One more technique I would like to share with you, that is dabbing technique with stenciling. So that also we are going to learn in this. So let's start. I will just set my camera on my working place properly, so it will be easier to see. And one more thing I would like to say, here we are going to give the vintage effect. There are various types of effect. Like first, whenever you are starting with one stroke paint, when we are starting with mixed media, you have to plan your idea, like suppose what exactly you want to make. Do you want to make a vintage effect? So any, old scenery if you are taking, or if you are just using all the household things, then for those things you can give the antique, or you can say the, oxidized effect you can use. So you have to plan your ideas first, and then accordingly you will take the color combination. So here, what today I thought I will, we are going to do it on box. So in boxes, of course, is multiple use. You can use it for anything. But basically, I got the idea that we can use it to put our accessories in that. So it will be related to beauty. So it has to be beautiful. So today what I'm going to do first, this is tin. So usually what we have to do, when we are doing of any metal, like when you are for the base, if you are using the metal, first we have to apply the color, because directly on the metal, the color or it won't set properly. It will take time. So first, what I did, I was already having this box at home, and I applied white color. So it has become very old, but no problem. We are going to apply one or two coats, maybe three coats. Like how for decoupage we have applied the base coat, that way, same way you have to apply the base coat on this. So now we are going to start. Now I said I am having few stones and shells and many, many things I'm having. So I'm going to use it this for today's session. So sometimes what happens, like this is, of course, this is stone. It will get stick with the Fevicol A+. But if the pebbles are very, very small, tiny, you can definitely use the Fevicol A+. Or else you can use Fevicol SH. Fevicol SH usually we are using for furniture purpose to stick the Sunmica with wood, so that the bond is stronger. So we can use it that, because if your shells are bigger, so it may come out after some time. Or if you are having a glue gun, it is not at all necessary. We are having nice strong adhesive with us, pidilite adhesive, so we can use that. But if you are in like, you know, you want to do it faster, or if you want to urgently, if you want to do a very big article, if you want to stick it on the center, then even glue gun you can use it. So first product what we are going to use it in this mixed media, that is A+. And then we are going to have all the colors, whichever colors, like that day also we have used acrylic colors. Again here we will be using maximum white color, but you can multiple colors, whichever combination you want to make, that is your freedom. I will be taking my own combination. So we will be using the acrylic colors. Acrylic colors that day also I showed in front of camera, the same way I'm showing now. You can take maximum two or three colors, not more than that. Then we can use metallic colors also. So metallic colors also we will be using in this. I have kept it few stencils which I would like to show you. This kind of stencils you are getting in the market. Even pidilite stencils are available in the market. You are having various types of design. So we will be using this too. And because I wanted to show you different techniques, you can use any one or two techniques from that particular, you know, whatever I'm showing you. Or else you can use, if the area is vast, like suppose if you are doing on canvas board size, say 12 by 1.5 feet longer, or 2 feet longer, or, you know, at approximately 24 inches by 12 inches area, you are having vast area. So you can do all my possible, techniques on the board. But if it is a very small one, you can do only 2 to 3 techniques. So here we will be starting. First, we will be doing on the lead, because that is the main, main surface which will be in vision, which will be visualized very clearly, and that will make our article most beautiful. So let's start. Okay. So now first I will set the camera down. So today first, what I did, I just stuck this kind of shell. But very first technique which I would like to show you, that is we are going to use one image. I said first I will be teaching you, we will be using the image. So I just took a printout, because it is related to beauty, so of course female will come. So what I am doing, I have taken simply one printout, normal Xerox paper plate. So I'm just taking that printout. Like this. Again, I'm repeating, when we are starting this mixed media article, you have to apply, if you are doing on glass or any surface, first apply 2 coats of acrylic color, acrylic white, which I am showing you here. So this is the color which we are going to use it for the base. So first, I'm not covering now because I already did 2 layers. So I'm just taking out little color for me.
Ma'am, is it acrylic white color that you're using?
It's acrylic white color.
Fevicryl acrylic white color.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. It's a big bottle that you're having. We get the small 35 rupees bottles.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Because usually what happens, we maximum we use white and black. So I always keep bigger bottle, but you do get smaller bottles also. When you are making box, at least you will be needing 25 ml color for one article to cover the surface. So I will be using,
Ma'am, if you can have that sponge and tell them the dabbing technique, because there is a question from Yashvi. She says, ma'am, can you please show us how to apply the coat on it? So even if you have a small sponge and just maybe possibly just show it to her in action.
Understand. Already kept it ready.
Okay.
Because I will not skip any, drop. But then I'm missing anything. Please let me know.
Yeah, there are a lot of things on the chat. So I'm just picking up the ones which are relevant only.
Yeah. So first, how we will cover this? Because whenever you are covering this base, you have to do previous day or 2 days before. Apply 1 coat. And then let it dry, say for around 6 hours or 8 hours, and then you can apply the second coat. So that is the reason I did it and I kept it. So I'm taking an ordinary sponge. Here again, I just took white color in the bowl, and I'm not adding any water in it. And I'm just taking with the sponge directly and dabbing on top of this lid. See, you don't have to apply color with brush, because when you are applying with the brush, your marks will come, the brush strokes marks will come, and it will take more time to cover the area. See, can you see the difference? When you are doing the work with a sponge, it is immediately covered in one coat, and if you are applying with the brush, the strokes are visible. And the layer is transparent, so you have to paint it at least, I think, so 4 to 5 times. So never go with the brush, always do with the sponge. It is faster, and the result what we want, we exactly getting that. And because when you are dabbing with the sponge, you are getting this kind of one texture which we wanted. If you can see from very closure, you can see the granules, small granules are there on the base, which we wanted. So that texture effect also, it looks very pretty. So first we will be applying the coat completely on the box or whatever article you are taking, whether you are doing on bottle or you are doing on canvas, you have to cover. Canvas is one of that medium which absorb the color very fast. So on canvas, you can definitely go with the brush, but remaining area, any solid area, which is not observable, like, it doesn't absorb the color. Those areas, you have to use the sponge only. So this way, you will be applying complete 1 coat and keep it for drying, see like this. Keep it for drying, say approximately it will take 1 hour, but you can keep for a little longer time, that is say 4 to 5 hours. So it will be completely total dry, and then after 1 coat complete dry, you can apply second coat. That way you have to apply 2 to 3 coats, then your base is ready to work, because then we can give all vintage effect, oxidized effect, whichever look you want to give on top of that, you can do it. Okay. Then again, for this base, I would like to share that if you want on black, now here I have done, see, this is my black background. So it is not at all necessary that you can use only white. You can use black acrylic color also. So whichever your choice, if you want to do the vintage effect or if you want to do the antique effect, then you can go for black color surface. And if you want to use colorful, the fresh look, then you will be going for the white base. So I'm going to do with related to, beauty. So of course I will be going for all fresh colors. So that is the reason I'm applying white color. So this way, I think so this is clear with everyone that we have to apply with the sponge. So simply dabbing technique. I'm putting this for drying. The same way I did it, this one. I said that first technique which I'm going to show you, that is transferring the image. Because usually when we are transferring the image, the procedure I will be explaining you. We are just applying there. You can use the decoupage glue. If it is not there, you can apply the Fevicol on the base. First, apply the one layer of glue. You can use the Fevicol A+ also. Normal MR Fevicol, which you are using for craft, that will do. So just apply one layer. And then you have to put your image reverse, means the picture side will go on the base and here you will stick the image with the base. And because of that, when you are just you have to keep it for drying. After 24 hours, you just have to wait this area and remove the upper blank, the white layer, which you can see now, it will come out. That is usually we do, but it takes 24 hours. But the same kind of effect, you can do it straight away, stick the image. That is the simplest way. So we are going to do that because that is faster and we can do many more things. So first I'm just taking A+ and with any brush, preferably flat brush, I'm just applying the glue here. Now this is my lead. I'm taking my image on the corner, so remaining area I can cover with different techniques. So first I will be applying the glue. If you want, you can take just watery brush, don't take much water because glue is stronger than too. I'm just taking weight brush to spread out the glue, that's it. That much water only you have to apply because this is simply the printout. So a normal printout will blot if water is more. So first I am applying here the glue and now I'm taking my image. I don't want this additional area I'm not sticking. I need her face. So first I will be sticking here. Instead of putting straight corner, you can simply tear the edges because we want that rough look. So what I'm doing, I'm just cutting her plane where I cut the edges with scissor. So instead of that, I'm tearing it because I want that effect, tearing effect. So you can see this, I'm simply tearing from all the sides. See, from all the sides, you can see it is, I want that uneven effect. So I'm just taking this image and I'm sticking on the lid. Okay. Now, with the rough cloth, you can simply press it. You can go from the center to all the sides. And somewhere if you find you need to stick it, apply the glue properly on the edges. Okay, so this way you can stick. If you want a colorful, a colorful printout, that will also do, no problem. Because we are going to color everywhere. So I have not taken, purposely I have not taken colorful because then the main subject will be you know, it will go on side, it won't look, you know, attractive, because she is the main subject from this particular article. So she has to look beautiful. So we will keep her in gray scale, and remaining area we will be doing colorful. So see, first what I did, I just took the image. Okay. Now the second thing what I am going to do. Now I will be using all accessories, like whatever things I am having with me. So first I am taking the key. So what is a beauty key? So it's a concept. Just randomly, you don't have to plan, like this side you can stick key or this side you cannot plan that way. When you are sticking this stuff anywhere, the way you want, you can just stick it. So first I'm sticking my big shells and key, and because this is metal, I will be using glue gun. I said you can use SH fevicol, that also, but I'm sorry, at present I was not having that, so I'm using glue gun, but you can definitely go for SH or MR will do, but MR I will not advise because it may come out with the thing. So my glue gun is hot already. So just what you have to do, simply you have to stick a very small drop, and you will be sticking near her face. If you want, you can, I'm showing you to sticking with glue also. So what I'm doing, I'm taking lot of glue. Here you need to have major quantity. So first we will be applying the glue, and now I'm taking few beads. You can simply 4-5, as many as you want, just stick it. If you are having the roses, so I'm having a small piece of lace. I don't have to use the whole thing. So whichever particular area, if I feel this design is okay, so I'm just separating, because I don't want very big area, very big piece, because I have to think, I have to stick so many things. So I'm just taking, we are applying this, we are using this lace generally on Rida, so you will be having lots of lace pieces at home. So somewhere you can take somewhere near here. So here, you know, don't no need to apply with the glue gun. We can directly, because this is fabric, normal fabric, zari ka hai, so we can directly stick with the A+. So fevicol A+, I'm taking. Here we are going to use the metallic colors. We are going to use few okay, so first I'm applied it. I'm putting here. I'm just pressing it for a moment so that it will stick. Okay, so this is done. Okay, now I will be sticking a few stones, shells. You can simply take one by one, make a very small I'm just using this is only for shell because I said earlier that it will not stick with a glue. Of course, it sticks, but it takes time, you know. And we, if you want to do it, so I'm speaking few flowers also. Again, I'm using glue. So majorly, we will be working with the glue. We will need lots of glue. So you can just take near her hair. You can apply glue over here. If you are having small beads or if you are having, you know, I'm having this piece. It was on my dress and it came out, so I can use it. I'm applying A plus. You can whatever fevicol you are using, you can, if you are not having A plus, you can use MR, no problem. But A plus is why I'm recommending A plus, because in A plus you can use it for any surface. You know, you can stick paper to paper, you can stick acrylic to paper, you can stick metal to metal. So we will be using A plus, and today I think my poor bottle. This is fourth bottle I'm using for my A plus, so I'm taking, because we will be needing lot of A plus, so I'm just directly I'm cutting from here and scooping it. Okay, so here again I will be using few stones, so I'm just putting it. You just have to wherever you want to stick the things, you just have to apply the glue and just sprinkle your things. See how I'm just squeezing it. I've taken new bottle, so I'm just squeezing it here and I'm just putting wherever I need to stick something. I'm just applying on top of that. I'm having few roses that also I will be using. This also, it was with my dress, so I just
thought. Aparna ma'am? Aparna ma'am, there is one viewer on YouTube, Miss Chandrika, who is requesting if you can take your camera closer to your article on which you are working. If it is
okay. Thank you, ma'am. Hello, Chandrika ma'am. Yes, definitely. I will zoom it.
This is Chandrika Bennor Gatta. One second. Beggar Hota. Miss Chandrika Beggar Hota, not Miss Chandrika Kamat.
Okay. So I'm just putting the glue. Wait, I will put on the this. So majorly, whatever things I'm having, you can see almost. I will put a little on higher side. So vision will be correct. This is proper angle. Because I will be working all around, so I'm going to make it, you know, I'm going to change my position again and again. So if it is not visible properly, please let me know. So whatever article like I want to stick, I'm just squeezing my glue and I'm just sticking all my material, more shells like this. Okay. So you can see many things I stuck. One more thing I would like to share, like suppose if you are having this acrylic colors and the fevicol, like if I want some texture, so how to create that texture? So for that, what I'm taking, I'm just taking my glue, my A plus on the OHP, or you can say on the plastic sheet, very less. You can add more glue. Then generally students are complaining like I'm having a lot of colors which have already become very thick. So what to do with them? So even I was having, I don't throw. So what I'm doing, I'm taking that color, thick color, which is dried. So even dried color, you don't have to throw. You can use the palette knife, or if you're not having palette knife, you can use butter knife, no problem. So here I'm showing on the OHP, I have taken the glue. Then I have taken the color, thick color. I'm taking little white in it. And I'm just mixing this color with A plus. Okay. So this color was thick. Sometimes in our bottle, if you are not using our color properly, if you are not closing our lid properly, the color becomes thicker like a paste. And then you really wondering how to use this. We have to throw. It is very costly color and we are throwing. So don't throw. Now what you have to do, see how I am mixing with palette knife or with you know, butter knife. You just have to mix with the Fevicol A plus. So you will get this nice thick paste, texture paste. And wherever you want to give the texture, you just have to apply like this. Somewhere if you want the texture, you can apply directly this color. If you want, you can, if you are having newspaper or any old paper, you can just crush it. You can, this printout what we had, we will take a small piece and just...
Aparna ma'am?
Yeah?
People are getting very anxious. They are not able to see it correctly. So if you can just bring down the camera a little bit towards your desk, desktop, towards your work area.
My camera is fixed at one position, ma'am.
Yeah, so, I know. I can understand.
Yeah, so I cannot.
Yeah, I know. It's okay, ma'am. Unless we should not be that we lose the entire view.
No.
Okay. That's it. Thank you so much.
Center?
Yeah, yeah, much better. It's more clear now.
Okay. So what we can do? We can just simply take the piece of paper. Instead of a normal paper, you can use the tissue paper also. So you just have to make the balls. Take this paste and just crumple it and you can normally stick it. So I'm just using the paste because I want this area. So what I'm doing, I'm just taking the paste like this and I'm just pouring it and with the knife, I'm giving the texture. Can you see this clearly? It is near camera I'm showing. Normally, you just have to apply the paste and in between, you are just slashing, giving the slashings. So you will get one kind of texture. After dry, it takes hardly 10 minutes to dry because A plus dries very fast. So you can do that way. Somewhere if you want, you can take with the fingertips and just give, you know, you just have to dip your finger and giving the texture like this. So you get this poppy effect. Here with the knife, I have given the slashing. Okay. So this way you can create the texture. When you are doing this kind of texturing, you have to do previous day. So it is easier and, you know, it is handy. So I think so this many things are sufficient for us where we have done the sticking part. Now, first very basic thing, we will be coloring. You can see lot many things we have stuck. So we have to give one base color, which we are going to use white. White acrylic color, I'm taking broad brush because we will be covering the whole portion. So what I'm doing, I'm taking acrylic color. I've not added water at all. I'm just taking plain color and I'm applying all over whatever things I have stuck. So on the lace, okay, you can see this. I'm not touching the image at all. This remaining area, I'm covering with the color, acrylic color. Okay, so now here on the top, I'm just sticking, covering almost with white. I'm just dabbing with my brush. If it is broader brush, it is easier and quicker. Here there is a glue, so I may stick one more shell here, like this. Okay. So first we will be covering the whole thing with white, because we are going to use multiple colors. So if, sorry. Okay. Just press it properly and then apply the. You can use this embroidery, you know, embroidery flowers if you are having, or any brooch of old dress. That also you can use it. This paper also, as soon as it will get dry, it will become harder. So if somewhere you find that it has not stuck properly, please lot of A plus and just put your things so it will get stick properly. Okay, so first I have colored my background as well as which things I stuck on the top. So here either you can use, just check it, always rotate your you know, the article. And now I'm covering my background area also, where I have not stuck anything, but still you have to cover the whole area with white. If you are using black color, then you will be using black. So first you can check it. See, even all the sides I am covering, because later on I won't be able to pick it up. So I'm covering this edges also properly. Give the proper finishing. Like this. This flower was dark color, then to on fabric you have to apply the color properly. So everything, some little bit I'm coming on her face. Because this paste is little weight, I'm not touching that at all. We'll do later on. So all the sides, I'm covering with the brush. Okay, so almost done. So now first you have to plan which color combination you with white, combination I'm going to take. So I'm going to use all my fresh colors. So I will be using you know, pink is there already, so little bit of sky blue, or here I'm going to use my shimmery colors, that is I'm having all, you know, sparkling colors. I will be showing you. This you can use. You can use the matte colors. That is the normal classic shades. If you are, of course, when the same sparkling colors, if you are adding with white, it will become matte finished colors. So I will be using few shades from that. And
the sparkling colors were also Fevicryl colors. Yes, you couldn't see the label.
Yeah.
This is the lilac kit. The second one which you showed was a lilac kit.
Yeah, this was the lilac kit. Lilac kit is the smaller one. This is the bigger kit.
Okay, sunflower.
Yeah, but sunflower. These are called Fevicryl colors, acrylic colors. See, these are the acrylic colors. You get the same bottle, single color also you can buy. The bottle will be this way. I will show you near the camera.
Yes, acrylic colors.
Okay, so this you get all different shades. So you can buy that. And these are the shimmer colors, but I just want this specific shades. So I don't want the shimmery effect, but I will be using with white. So this blue, I love this blue. Okay. So I will be using this color.
Thank you.
Yeah, ma'am. Thank you. Here I am taking little color. Here in mixed media, we are not going to use water at all. We are just simply going to use the direct colors. So here I am taking green, little bit of green here, and with white I will be using. So first what I am doing, just cleaning my knife first. You have to wait till it's dry. This little wait you can see. So what we can do, take a fresh dry brush. And now I will be coloring. I have taken, this is sparkling blue, okay, shimmery blue. So what I'm doing, I'm just applying, I'm giving the dry effect. I'm not completely touching the surface. From the top, very gently, I'm just applying on top of this lace piece. So I will be using blue. Simultaneously, I'm not washing my brush. Same brush, immediately I'm dipping in green and I'm giving this effect. See. Somewhere you can just give the wherever you want blue. Yeah, it has little set. You can see my clay, this particular paste with old color has settled down. So very gently, I'm applying white color on top of that. I'm just touching my brush. I'm not dragging it because if I will drag, it will get disturbed. The layer will get disturbed. So I'm just simply dabbing my brush on top of that. If you are working under the fan, it will dry faster. I'm sitting under, this AC is on, so it will take a little more time to dry. But it's okay. We are not going to disturb that area at all. So here, it is near the camera now. So we will be wherever you want. I'm going to use first only blue and green. Later on, wherever you want to apply other color, you can definitely. Randomly. Somewhere like these things will take time to stick. So what you can do, simply you can take the sponge, dab your color in the sponge. Little white, I'm dabbing my sponge. See, I've taken color in the sponge, then little white because I don't want very dark color shade. So I'm dabbing it so my excess color will come out. And now I can simply give from the top, I just simply touch this. So everywhere, only that raised part will get colored. Remaining will stay white as it is. Again, this side, I'm giving little blue, only blue. Here I'm adding little green. Just giving the dabbing thing because I want this texture. Now with the brush, I'm taking two colors together and near her face, I'm giving dry stroke with colors. I'm not covering her whole face, but somewhere I want blue, somewhere I'm using green, and I'm just covering this area. If you want, you can put somewhere the with knife. So I'm just putting one droplet like this. You can see how I did it. I just took one knife first, cleaning it, taking second color, taking the green color, very little scoop in my knife, and then I'm just putting near her face, okay, like this, and I'm dragging it on top. So it will give as if color dew drop is falling on her face. So this you have to do very carefully, see like this. Okay, so in short, you have to cover her image side area with something or the other, because it should not look as if you have stuck something on the base. So I'm taking here again. Now on the sides, I can apply the dark color. Somewhere the green I'm applying, I'm showing you this like this, see. The green color I have applied, I'm not washing my brush, and now I'm taking directly the blue color and mixing in that. So somewhere the blue shade will come, somewhere the green shade will come. We are just changing because I don't want the lid should be completely white. Okay, so edges, I'm just giving the strokes, then I will be showing, because reverse I cannot do, it should be visible. Now I have applied here, I have applied green, here I have applied blue. What I'm doing with the same brush, I'm applying on top of that white, little bit white, but very gently to give shading effect. I don't want very plain white, or neither I want plain green. So somewhere it is dark, see. Like this. Okay. So again, here I want to use blue because major or green is visible. So I'm using the blue somewhere, but I'm dabbing with my brush. I'm not applying straight away. I'm just dabbing my brush because I want that effect. Somewhere I can just take little lilac matte color, which I will be here. I'm just dropping the color because this area is still wet. See, when you are giving a dabbing directly with the brush, you get this kind of effect. See the effect here. I applied the color and very slowly and gently I'm giving the dabbing effect. I will be coloring this area same way. So I'm just applying the color first. Because it is not 100% dried, you have to do it very carefully. Otherwise, If it is dried, you can directly apply with a dry brush. I think so. Now is clearly visible, ma'am. I think so. I'm clearly visible. So I have taken three colors. One is a lilac, or you can say lavender color. This direct shades you get in the market. So whichever color combination you want to use, you can use it. Now I have applied. See, you have to balance the design. So here I have used lilac color, then pearl, shimmer blue and green. So I will be giving little touch from this particular side also. Because it should not look, you have to always balance your design from all the sides. Here also I can give the drop effect. So again, it is up to you how you want to make it, you know. Simply I'm applying the colors. So almost I completed this first piece. Take a little bit more. I'm simply dabbing the area. See, my lead is ready. Is it looking beautiful? I hope everyone got the idea. What I did, simply first I stuck the image, then whatever things you want to stick it on the top area, plan it where to stick what, and then you just have to apply the color from top with the sponge only. I'm just dabbing it, nothing else I have done in this. Now I'm showing you on the sides what to do. I will be putting this on some height. Now, for the box, what we have to do? It's done. Shall I keep this aside for drying? And then I will be showing you. Let it dry for some time. Now, in the background also, we cannot keep the box just like that. So again, we will be applying, take dry brush. First, I'm washing it because my pink is there inside. So first, I will be washing my brush, taking very, very dry brush. First, apply white color. Is it visible? Clearly visible? First, I'm applying the white color. So I'm taking little green in it. And just giving the dry effect. Same way, I'm not washing my brush. I'm dipping in white and just giving the halka. Somewhere the color is darker, somewhere it is, the effect is coming. Somewhere it is light, somewhere it is dark. I will be showing you later on what I'm doing. So first, I'm just applying white color. In the base, with the same brush, I'm taking green. Again, I'm applying because this is not round, this is not square, the shape is hexagon. So I'm moving my article. See, somewhere it is coming. Again with white. First cover all the sides. Now I cannot put down. Okay. So you can see I have covered all the area randomly. Somewhere green is dark, somewhere it is light. Okay. Now what we are going to do, let it wait just for 1 minute to dry. Now what I'm doing, I'm showing you at one side near this camera. Now I will be taking blue. So same blue, because I have taken on the top. So same blue I am using. I am taking little blue on the plastic. And with dry, I am not adding anything in that. I am just giving random effect. Again I am taking white and I am dragging. So somewhere my, see the shading. Somewhere the blue part will be more darker. That way you have to cover the sides. I will be doing little bit this way and then I will be showing you, because it is difficult for me to hold for longer time. So I'm just doing one side. I'm randomly giving the green and blue strokes with white. If you want, when you are sticking your things, again, before painting, you can stick few beads if you want, but this is a cookie, already the dates are raised up. So I did not, I did not do anything on top of that. I'm just showing you the shading work. Simply I'm taking blue, somewhere I'm taking green. Even I will be needing green here. Okay. I hope it is clearly visible now.
Yes, ma'am. There are lovely comments as awesome, lovely, beautiful, soothing color. Wow, amazing.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Actually, I won't be able to see the comments, and second thing, like the shape is hexagon, so I cannot hold it in the same one position.
Correct.
So that is the only thing. But
no, it's very clear, and you are explaining it very, very well.
Thank you.
And you're going so slow that I'm sure everybody is getting, they're lost in your creativity.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. So the same way, you just have to apply. See, all over. Now here, one technique which you can do it, I will be telling you now, but immediately we cannot see that effect. What you can do, like after it's completely dry, we'll wait in the final, say remaining 15-20 minutes. If that time, if it is completely dry, I can show you that effect. What you can do, we have applied, first we applied the white color. Then somewhere I applied green randomly. I have not planned anything. I'm just moving my brush and this effect has come very naturally. I have not created anything. Then let it dry completely. Then what you can do, you can take the candle, normal candle, and you can just rub on everywhere, on the surface. Okay, so just rub the candle, and if you are having sandpaper at home, you can just on top of that, you can rub. If I second box, we are going to do it little antique effect. If I can show you the same effect there, but I'm sorry, I was not having candle. I was planning that, but I did not get it at my place. So I'm just explaining you, if you can try it out. After you apply the color, two colors, two shades or three shades randomly, and then rub the candle all over on the surface. And then after say 2 hours, you can just apply or you can rub the polished paper on top of that. So what will happen? Somewhere the candle wax will stay as it is, and somewhere the color will come out. It will peel off. So it gives the vintage effect, old effect, antique effect. It looks very pretty, you know. So I have done almost this box, because here already dates are raising up, so I have not applied more color. So see, the box is ready with the coloring, and when you are putting on top of this, I'm not closing it. Just check the effect of box now. I'm showing you all sides first. See, from all the sides, it will match. Somewhere the lid is dark, somewhere it is light. And from the top, all the colors. And if you want extra effect, what you can do it. Just now it came in my mind. So if you are having glitter, you know, the powder glitter, what you can do, you can just sprinkle all over on the top. So the blue, the purple, those colors are already fresh colors. And when the silver powder, if you are sprinkling from the top, it will, you know, it will shine more. So then it will look more pretty.
So, Aparna, there's one question. They said that the candle technique, can it be used on any surface, or should it be restricted only to metals?
No, you can use the candle technique for metal surface. Wooden surface will give the best result if you are doing on wood. Other only on glass, don't try that effect, because a glass surface is very smooth. So when you are rubbing your candle, the base will come out, or it may get spoiled. So don't do it that technique on glass. Otherwise, remaining any hard surface like wood, then metal, then acrylic, you can try that. But base should be solid. And if you are giving this kind of texture and then applying the candle, then you get better result. Rather, I will say best result. So this we almost finished first article. So
do you have any picture of the candle effect on an article that you have done? Just for us to get an idea.
But I have not taken with me at present.
Okay, ma'am. No problem. Thank you so much.
I will be sending you the picture, no problem.
Yeah, sure. I'll share it on the group that we have.
So I will be sending.
Thank you.
So this way we have first very simple, you know, a simplest way. We finished first mixed media article. So this way you can do the first. Now, otherwise also we have done one lead. So I will be showing you the second technique. That is antique gold effect, or you can say antique effect. So for that, I will be needing the box. Excuse me. Sorry for the inconvenience. Because this was not planned, but then I thought I'm telling you, showing you. So here, this is the second one. We can go for wood also, but this is handy. So I'm showing you the different antique effect. But I said like earlier, if we are doing antique effect, we need the black surface. Okay, so here we will be using black color. So now I'm taking, first we will take black acrylic color, same the way we used white. I'm taking very less color first. We will be doing same way, dabbing technique. Again, here I will be showing you one more technique, that is, we are not going to use this. We will be using small beads. So first, wherever I want, now this is metal. Like suppose if I want to change the color combination, now it is not that handy. So what a simple way you can do, you can add glue in the color or just apply glue on your this particular surface. Just squeeze it all over. Then I'm adding with my black color also. I'm squeezing the glue in my black acrylic color. Now what I'm doing, first I will be using the brush for glue. Wash it if color is there inside. Applying the glue first.
Ma'am, which glue are you using now for mixing with the color as well as
same? What is, we are doing with this only.
A plus.
Okay. Fevicol A plus. This is the multi-purpose glue. It is Fevicol only, but the speciality of this glue is the consistency is thicker and it sticks almost all different surfaces. Like you can stick acrylic to paper, then plastic to paper, then you can cardboard to paper, almost all possible areas it will stick with this glue. So we are going to use this one, and here what I'm going to use it, I'm taking normal paper, okay? I'm just tearing the pages and I'm giving different texture. So first I applied the glue. I'm just tearing the paper and sticking on top of this. See, texturing or what designing I'm teaching you, I'm trying my best, which is easily available at home. Those many things only you can use. Just overlap the piece of papers to each other because we want little texture. So rough texture we want. Even if you have not applied any surface, any color on the surface will do. So first on the same plain glue, I have applied the papers. Now what I'm doing, I have taken black color, I have added glue in it, little water I am adding so that my brush can move smoothly. So I have taken black color plus glue, mix it thoroughly. We may need more water, so just add it with the brush normally. So this paste is black color, acrylic color plus Fevicol A plus. So there is no any proportion. You can take a little bit of Fevicol. There is no specific measurement of color and mixing the Fevicol. It's the way little bit you have to add up because it will help us to stick faster. And color will come, nice coat will come on the surface. So that is the reason we are adding the Fevicol in the color. So same way I have added, and now I will be applying here from the top just to cover the area. If you want 3D effect, you can instead of sticking plain paper, you can crumple the paper like this and then stick. But I don't want that effect. I want the cutout effect only. So I'm simply cutting the paper and sticking it. We'll see the magic later on after drying how it looks. So all over I'm applying the black color. You can notice one thing, like when we are adding Fevicol in the color, it spreads very fast and it dries very fast. Simultaneously we are sticking the material, so no need to apply base coat. You can do this technique directly on any surface, on wood, glass, on metal, everywhere you can use the same technique. I have just simply added my paper like this. So first, now I'm covering the whole area with black, because this will be with black effect, antique effect I'm showing you. Where I have not applied the piece of paper, that area will give the granule effect. Of course, I cannot show you from here because we applied white color with the sponge. So you will have that round granule effect on plain area. And where I have stuck this paper pieces, there you will find, which you can see later on when we will do the coloring from top. So first I'm applying this one area, one layer I applied. I'm covering the edges also.
Ma'am, a question on YouTube. Can all these techniques be used on bottle also?
Yeah, you can. On bottle, if you are using these techniques, first I will recommend to cover the whole bottle with piece of paper. Like first you dilute the Fevicol little bit. Very little, like suppose 1 spoon of Fevicol if you are taking, you add 2 to 3 drops of water in it, dilute it, apply on the glass bottle, and then just tear the paper, start sticking. Or else simply you can take the tissue paper and you can just give one layer to the surface. So you will get nice matte effect, and then you can work on it.
Thank you, ma'am.
Now my this area, if I let it dry, you can, from the close-up I am showing you, if you can make out paper pieces where I have stuck, you can see the tearing, you know, teared piece effect you can make out easily. If it is drying, I'm just moving, so because of light it may be visible. Can you see this? The crackle effect you can make out where I have stuck the piece of paper, and on the top I just apply color with the sponge. So round effect, that is not that visible, but the down portion where I stuck the piece of papers, that you can make out. Of course, after coloring it will be more nicely visible, but I just wanted to show you the difference why we did that. Now,
question that, will the glue spoil the brush?
Will, pardon ma'am, I did not get it.
Will the glue spoil the brush? Because we are using the glue with the help of a brush. So will it spoil the brush?
This is actually, it is water dissolvable glue. Fevicol, it dissolves in the water. So it will not, it won't spoil your brush. But immediately, whenever see you, if you are noticing how I'm using my brush and I'm putting in the water. So whenever you are completing your work, immediately you should wash your brush thoroughly, clearly, with 3 to 4 times. But it will not spoil your brush because this glue is diluable, means
water-based.
So it won't spoil. But if you are putting your brush just like that without washing, it will become harder. Correct. And then it will become normal, but not like previous one.
Correct.
So please, whenever it is, always we say, like, if you are doing the painting work, you finish your painting and immediately you should wash your brush in 3 to 4 times in clear water. Till you get clear water, you have to wash your brush. So then the life, it will stay for longer time. Okay. So now, again, here I will be using, I'm using this in kitchen. I'm having this. So I will be using this. Glue. Almost all the glues I have tried. You need to have flat surface where you are sticking your this kind of embellishments. These are the embellishments. This is actually metal, so it will take time to stick. Then I'm using small beads. Again, I will be using the glue. Randomly, you are pouring. Somewhere, just go. You can create your design with the glue itself. But it takes time to dry. You can make your own design directly with the glue. See, you get this designed embellishment also, which you are going to stick it on the surface. But if you are having good hand, you can directly do this with the glue. See, and you can use the dryer for drying this glue because it will take time to dry. I'm applying very thick, but you can see the design. I'm doing this directly with the glue. So after drying, this glue will become transparent and then you are applying the color on top of that. So you cannot make out whether you have stuck the embellishment or you have done the designing with the glue. But I just wanted to show you, like, with the help of this glue, we can make your own design. So I'm just using glue itself directly. See, when you are doing your work, that time many ideas comes in your mind. So everything I said, you cannot plan. The way you start your designing, you know, a mixed media is such a beautiful art form. It gives you full freedom. The way you want to do and wherever you want to start your work, you can simply start and complete. So you can see with the glue only I did this designing. So it will dry. And here I will be sticking something. So I'm taking small beads. I'm having few half cut pearls, so I will be using that. So I'm taking very less pearls. And you just have to randomly put on top of this. So I'm not disturbing this design. I'm just, because the glue is white, even this pearls are white, so it may not be very clearly visible. I'm showing you from near. you just have to press it. You are just putting your half cut pearls. You can somewhere you can put the bigger one also. So you are just sticking on the glue like this. Okay, so somewhere I will be taking bigger one, so it will be visible. That is where I put it. So from here, if I'm taking the bigger one, it will be visible for you. I think so, now it is visible. So somewhere you can take the small one, somewhere you can take the bigger one. You just have to stick it randomly wherever you want. Just put it in the glue and press it, so it will take the own position. See, only matter is whenever you are sticking this kind of embellishments or any attachments from the top, it takes time to dry. You know, this is not instant work that you have started and you will finish in 10 minutes. So a few things you have to go step by step. Like first you will be applying the base coat. You have to wait till it gets complete dry. Then again, you will be using, you know, you will be doing few sticking things. Then again, you have to wait. So this is part by part you have to do. That is why like many videos, if you have seen, they are using glue gun because that is the only option. It covers faster. But doesn't matter if you can wait, and if you are doing your own art form, of course you will take time, you will think, and then accordingly you will do it. So it is worth waiting. So this way I'm sticking all my beads. I will be putting this design as it is somewhere now in this corner. What I can take. I can take the sponge, small pieces of, see. You know, any possible thing you can stick. I'm taking very small, small pieces. I'm cutting. Now I will be applying the glue in this corner. This corner I have stuck some beads. This area I'm covering. You can see the sponge effect, it looks lovely. Just take the sponge piece, always cut small, small one. And one by one, you just have to stick it. Okay, so this way, I said if there are n number of ideas you get while working. I'm just taking small, small piece. This sponge, when we are using for dabbing technique, or sometimes we are covering the larger area, we are painting larger area with the sponge. So what happens, like it becomes hard and then we are just throwing. Proudly say I don't throw them. I put them because it becomes harder, and then this way we can use it. So there is a, you know, we can give this texture with the help of sponge. I'm just sticking it all over in one corner. That's it. I think so. This much are sufficient. Like this. If you are having sand at home, or if you are having, you know, the small granules, or this very, very small bits I'm having very less. It is not, you know, handy also to remove, but you can use the very small bits and you just spread the glue, and on top of that you can put the those beads also. So here I'm using few. Like I remember one of my students' mother, she called me and she told me, "Ma'am, I just wanted to talk to you." I said, "Okay, yeah, ma'am, what you want to say?" She said, "What you are teaching in your college?" I said, "Why? My daughter is gathering everything. You know, kuch bhi pada hua mala toot gayi le liya. Kuch necklace tha to wo toot gaya wo le liya." सब इकट्ठा करती रहती है पूरा टाइम. सो आई सेड कि सो शी सेड आई एम रियली वंडरिंग कि वो करती क्या है, हर चीज इकट्ठा करती रहती है जब भी. देन आई सेड ओके मैम, हैव यू सीन हर आर्टिकल एनी टाइम, व्हाट शी इज डूइंग, और डिड यू आस्क लाइक वेयर शी इज यूजिंग? इतना सब जमा करती है कचरा, आप बोल रहे हो, कंप्लेन कर रहे हो. सो आपको पता है वो कहाँ पे यूज करती है? सो शी सेड कि पता तो नहीं है, बट अभी तो मैं डेफिनेटली देखना चाहूंगी कि इतना वो कचरा जमा करके जब भी कोई भी चीज टूट फूट जाए, शी विल से मामा डोंट थ्रो, ये मेरे काम आएगा, आप रख दो, आप रख दो. सो एवरी टाइम शी सेड के अच्छा ऐसे जमा करते तो आप प्लीज मैम बताइए आप करवाते क्या हो. देन आई हैड दिस लास्ट ईयर वर्कशॉप, सो मैंने उनको ये आर्टिकल बताया. जैसे अभी मैंने ये बॉक्स किया है वैसे वो बॉक्स किया हुआ आई शोड हर, and that I took their article on canvas, and the thing the canvas was with her in the college, so her mother could not see that. Usko kaam baki tha uspe, so she said ki jaise khatam hota hai I will carry home. And when she her mother saw that, she was so surprised ki itne sare wo kiye hue kachre uthaye jo usne rakha tha that she has used, and she could not believe ki itna खूबसूरत उसमें से कुछ बन सकता है. सो कहने की बात ये है कि समटाइम्स लाइक जैसे मैं अभी आपको ये बता रही हूँ, आप बोलोगे अपना व्हाट आर यू शोइंग, ये क्या कर क्या रहे हो आप, कब से ये ले रहे हो वो ले रहे हो चुपका रहे हो, बट यू नो इन्हीं सब चीजों को मिला के इतना सुंदर आर्ट फॉर्म एक रेडी हो जाता है ना. अभी देखिए ये मेरा काम पूरा जो मुझे चिपकाने का था वो हो गया. अभी एज यूजुअल जैसे मैंने पहले वाले में व्हाइट कलर किया था, इसमें मैं ब्लैक कलर करूँ. सो बहुत मजा आता है जब पेरेंट्स ऐसे मतलब कुछ पूछते हैं, एंड देन उनको भी खुशी होती है कि अरे हमने कुछ और सोचा था, एंड यू नो कुछ नया देखने मिल गया. एंड देन दे रियली फील प्राउड फॉर देयर किड्स के अरे मेरा बच्चा कुछ नया कर रहा है, कुछ हटके कर रहा है. सो इवन आई फील दैट इज यू नो आई टेक इट वेरी प्राउडली एज माई सक्सेस. सो आई विल कंटिन्यू हियर. आई ओके अभी ये भी बीच बीच में मैंने डाल दिए हैं. अब हाउ आई एम डूइंग, फर्स्ट आई विल बी कवरिंग दिस पोर्शन बिकॉज दिस इज सॉलिड एरिया. सो फर्स्ट आई एम जस्ट डैबिंग माय ब्लैक कलर ऑन टॉप ऑफ दिस ऑल बीड्स जो मैंने चिपकाए हैं. हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू पीपल आर गेटिंग आइडियाज. अभी आप भी ये शुरू करो, बट प्लीज किसी मम्मी की कोई अच्छी वाली चीज तोड़ के मत लेना, वरना आपके मम्मी के कॉल्स मुझे आ जाएंगे. जो टूटा फूटा सामान है वो आप डेफिनेटली यूज कर सकते हो. जैसे यहाँ पे अभी मैं स्पंज के ऊपर कलर ही कर रही हूँ, सो आई विल बी यूजिंग स्पंज ओनली टू डैप एंड इट विल गेट सोक प्रॉपरली. सो क्या होगा, जैसे ही मेरा कलर पूरा अंदर पेनिट्रेट हो जाएगा, ये देखिए कलरिंग फटाफट हो रहा है. सो वी विल बी यूजिंग स्पंज लाइक दिस. इसमें जल्दी जल्दी चिपक जाता है और कलर भी फास्ट होता है. सो बिकॉज दिस वॉज स्पंज पीसेस, जहां पे गैप लगे आप कलर पूरा ये डाल दीजिएगा. अब सेम इस तरफ भी मैं वैसे ही करूंगी, मैं बार बार रिपीट कर रही हूँ, जब भी आप ये बेस का कलर करते हो, बेस का कलर करने के बाद यू हैव टू वेट, गीले में आपको तुरंत ही तुरंत ऊपर का काम नहीं करना है, उसको सूखने देना है। उसके बाद में जब आप ये सारे ऐसे ये सारे एक्सेसरीज जो है या एम्बलिशमेंट्स जो आप चिपकाते हो, ये चिपकाने के बाद में भी आपको रुकना है, बट हम ज्यादा रुक नहीं सकते हैं। इसके लिए मैं तुरंत कर रही हूँ, गीले में बहुत संभाल के कर रही हूँ, बट प्लीज आप जब कर रहे हो आप रुक रुक के कीजिए, उसको ड्राई होने दीजिए, वरना वो सेट नहीं होगा और निकल आएगा। बिकॉज ये मैंने पहले ही बोला, ये ग्लू बहुत स्ट्रांग है, लेकिन जब तक उसको सूखने का टाइम नहीं मिले वो कुछ नहीं कर सकता। एक बार वो सूख गया तो बहुत बढ़िया इफेक्ट देता है, दैट यू विल कम टू नो। अभी देखोगे आप लोग, अभी सब चीजों को मैं पहले ब्लैक कलर से कवर कर रही हूँ, बिकॉज हमें इसके ऊपर एंटीक इफेक्ट देना है। वी आर गोइंग टू यूज गोल्ड, वी आर गोइंग टू यूज ब्रॉन्ज, वट एवर, लाइक आपको गोल्ड में चाहिए, थोड़ा सा एंटीक इफेक्ट चाहिए, तो आप उसको ब्रॉन्ज या गोल्ड या कॉपर यूज कर सकते हो। ये अभी तक मेरा पूरा सूखा नहीं है, सो आई एम डूइंग वेरी केयरफुली। इवन दिस आई विल बी कवरिंग, ये एक तरफ से अभी तक चिपका नहीं है पूरी तरह से, कोई बात नहीं, विल स्टिक इट, इट्स मूविंग थोड़ा टाइम के बाद। ये देखिए अभी मेरा ऑलमोस्ट, मैंने जो चीज लगाया था ये ग्लू को छोड़ के सारा मैंने ब्लैक कर लिया है। ये ग्लू का लाइन देखिए, ये सूख गया है, सो मैं ये भी यहाँ पे मैंने पूरा कलर कर लिया है। इसको एक बार ऐसे प्रेस कर देती हूँ, कहाँ चिपकना अगर बाकी रह गया हो तो वो चिपक जाएगा। सी माय कलर इज डन ऑलमोस्ट, ये पूरा काला मैंने कर दिया है। सो अभी आई विल बी वेटिंग फॉर जस्ट वन मोमेंट टू ड्राई, थोड़ा मुझे रुकना जरूरी है अभी। बाय दैट टाइम हम एक काम करते हैं, स्टूडेंट्स की कोई क्वेश्चंस हो या कोई क्वेरीज हो आप डेफिनेटली मुझे पूछ सकते हो। आपको किसी को कुछ पूछना है यू कैन आस्क मी नाउ, बिकॉज अदरवाइज ऑल्सो आई हैव टू वेट इट टिल इट ड्राइज, मुझे उसको थोड़ा टाइम देना पड़ेगा। किसी के कोई क्वेश्चंस है?
There are not many, but there is one participant, Susan, who is watching on YouTube. She's saying, I've used shell and thread to decorate my wine bottle, and it is also painted with shells. So it looks beautiful.
Wow. You can paint it. Shells are, naturally, they are having very beautiful shape. And it looks, see, if you can see, I have painted few shells. It was white in naturally, those are always white, majorly. But you can paint it with acrylic colors. If you can see this, I have painted with a sparkling color. It glitters. This is sparkling pink. So the same way you can, if you don't want to cover everything with one color, you can simply color your shells and then you can stick it. That is also no problem.
Okay. Ma'am, and there was one participant who's been asking since the time you made that pink, the palette knife texture. Wants to know whether can you repeat that 3D texture that you made using Fevicol and old paints?
Yeah.
Or you can just show, speak about the...
Because in one college where I went, there few students, they complained that our colors are drying fast, ma'am. Why it is happening that way, we don't understand. So from that particular point, I got the idea. So even if your colors are dried, you don't throw the bottles. You just take out the color with, palette knife, or you can use the butter knife and add a Fevicol A+ in it and make a thick paste. And then you can use it as a texture paste. So what you just have to add color, the thick color which already dried, that color paste you take it, then add Fevicol A plus little bit and nicely you mix it the way I mixed it here, and then you can use it as a texture paste. Second idea I will give, please don't throw your colors and don't waste like that. Use them in creativity. So the aise nobati nahi aayegi ki wo color sukh jaye, but agar texture paints ka second ek main aapko ek bolti hu ki you take the Fevicol A plus aur hamara jo normal talcum powder jo hota hai, talcum powder aajkal ladkiyan bahut kam lagati hai, but then to agar ghar pe powder pada hai, so you can mix with the Fevicol A plus. That is the that is why we always prefer this blue. It is really very very comfortable and handy to to use, and sticks bhi bahut jaldi se kar deta hai. So for that you can talcum powder aur uske andar a Fevicol A plus mix kar dijiye. Dheere 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 hilate jaiye, so you will get a nice texture paste milega aapko, jo aap seedha laga dijiye jahan pe bhi aapko kaam karna hai, and simply aap finger se dabbing kar sakte hain, to aapko ek utha hua texture milega. Agar aap knife se ya pencil se ya brush ke end se dusre wale end se agar aap uske upar aise hi brush ko ghumate, to you are getting a specific texture. To is tarah se aap alag alag texturing ke liye wo paste ka istemal zarur kar sakte ho. Any
Yeah, ma'am, one can be they would like to see your stenciling technique which you had mentioned earlier.
Yeah, stenciling hum yahan pe karne hi wale hain. That is the reason I am waiting that mera sukh na jaye. Ab dekhiye ye mera jo Fevicol hai wo bhi thoda thoda dry ho gaya hai. I am not moving my brush, I am just dabbing it with from with the brush. ऊपर ऊपर से मैं सिर्फ उसको व्हाइट कलर को कवर कर रही हूँ. ये सूखने के बाद बहुत बढ़िया कलर देगा, बट वी हैव टू वेट. अभी यहाँ का जो पोर्शन है वो सूख गया है, सो आई एम शोइंग यू द स्टेंसिलिंग इफेक्ट. स्टेंसिलिंग के लिए मैंने आपको पहले स्टेंसिल्स बताए थे, ऐसे वाले स्टेंसिल्स रेडी आते हैं. तो आपको जहां पे स्टेंसिलिंग इफेक्ट चाहिए तो उसके लिए हम क्या करेंगे, you can take metallic color or whichever color you want. मैं इसमें से metallic color निकाल लेती हूँ. हम bronze use कर सकते हैं. अभी मैं क्या कर रही हूं, थोड़ा सा पहले हम लोग कलर निकाल लेंगे. ब्रॉन्ज मैं ले सकती हूँ, प्रॉपर जो भी आपको शेड लेना है पहले वो कलर हम लोग निकालेंगे. स्टेंसिलिंग वर्क भी जब करते हैं तो आपको एक बात का ध्यान रखना है कि इसमें भी आपको पानी नहीं मिलाना है. आई एम जस्ट टेकिंग वेरी थिक कलर, ये देखिए. मैंने ब्रॉन्ज कलर ले लिया है. अब जो भी डिजाइन हमें करना है, जैसे मैं ये इतने ही पोर्शन में करने वाली हूं, सो व्हाट आई एम डूइंग, आई एम जस्ट स्किपिंग दैट एरिया, इस तरफ का लेती हूं. जहां पे भी हमें जो एरिया में हमें अपना काम करना है, हम लोग क्या करेंगे, उतने एरिया में पहले डिजाइन को प्लेस करना है इस तरह से, और उसके बाद में नीचे वाला एरिया जो है वो हमेशा सूखा हुआ जरूरी है, मतलब सूखा हुआ ही होना चाहिए. यू गेट दिस काइंड ऑफ टूल्स डैबिंग के लिए. आप ये वाले टूल्स ऐसे सेट मिलता है, 3 का 5 का 7 का. So this is sponge और पीछे handle है, तो it is easy to handle. Just आपको color लेना है ये, और उसके ऊपर आपको सिर्फ dab करना है. ये देखिए, आप अगर आपके पास ये टूल नहीं है कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं, आप डायरेक्टली पीस ऑफ स्पंज से भी काम कर सकते हो। ऐसा कुछ नहीं है कि हमें यही टूल्स चाहिए, आप डायरेक्टली जैसे मैंने अभी पीस ऑफ स्पंज से पहले डैबिंग किया था नॉर्मल कलर, वैसे ही आप कर सकते हो। सो आई एम जस्ट अप्लाइंग द कलर। ये पकड़ने के लिए आसानी होती है इसके लिए, एंड आई एम रिमूविंग माई स्टेंसिल। ये देखिए इतना खूबसूरत डिजाइन यहाँ पे बन गया। सी, ये स्टेंसिल वर्क बहुत बढ़िया है कि जिसमें आपको मतलब डिजाइनिंग का ज्यादा कुछ नहीं जम रहा है, आप डायरेक्टली इस तरह से बीच बीच में स्टेंसिलिंग डाल सकते हो। ओके, अभी मैं उसके साथ में आपको दूसरा और एक कलर देंगे, बिकॉज एक ही कलर से सब जेल नहीं होगा, उसके साथ में आपको कॉन्ट्रास्ट भी लेना है। So now I am using the another color. This is again different color I am using. जो मैं अभी इसके ऊपर में लगा दूंगी। What I am doing? I am taking the color directly with on my fingertip. पहले मैं यहाँ पे निकाल रही हूँ, इसमें मैं ब्रश भी इस्तेमाल नहीं करूंगी और स्पंज भी इस्तेमाल नहीं करूंगी। जहां जहां मुझे गोल्ड का इफेक्ट, ब्रॉन्ज का इफेक्ट देना है, उसके ऊपर मैं सिर्फ फिंगर से डैप कर रही हूं। आप देखिए जो उठी हुई चीजें हैं, जिधर रेज्ड इफेक्ट है वहां पे मेरा ये हाईलाइट हो जाएगा। आई एम पुटिंग इट डाउन। वापस से मैं थोड़ा कलर ले रही हूँ। ये आप फिंगर से ही करोगे, जहां पे हमने जो चीजें लगाई है, चिपकाई है, वो सारी हमारी ऐसे कवर हो जाए। आप चाहिए तो अगर आपको थोड़ा ज्यादा गोल्ड पसंद है तो ज्यादा येलो गोल्ड वाला भी आता है। मैं वैसा बहुत कम इस्तेमाल करती हूँ, बट अगर आपको चाहिए तो आप यूज कर सकते हो डेफिनेटली। देखिए अभी मैं यहाँ पे जहां जहां मैंने बीड्स लगाए हैं, मैं कैमरा के पास आके बताती हूँ आपको लगा के। सी दिस, आई एम जस्ट डैबिंग विथ माई फिंगर टिप। तो सो जहां जहां आपका जो छोटी छोटी चीजें चिपकी हुई है, यू कैन सी दिस नजदीक से, वो उस पे कवर हो रहा है, उस पे कलर आ रहा है। ओके, सो बता देती हूँ करके। जिधर आप डिजाइन होगा आपका डिजाइन के ऊपर हाईलाइट होगा, पूरा ब्लैक जो था वो आपका जहां जहां हमें वैसे डिजाइन चाहिए थी वो इसके ऊपर ही। मैं पूरा कवर नहीं कर रही हूँ, कहीं कहीं डैप कर रही हूँ ताकि उतना ही एरिया वो, जैसे अभी आपको ये क्लियर दिखेगा उसको हाईलाइट करने के बाद। नाउ वी विल गिव द ड्राई इफेक्ट विद द ब्रश विथ सेम कलर विथ एंटी गोल्ड। उसके लिए मैं ड्राई ब्रश सूखा वाला ले रही हूँ, उसको थोड़ा हेयर को थोड़ा स्प्रेड कर रही हूँ ताकि एक साथ एक जगह पे बहुत सारा कलर ना लगे। इसके ऊपर भी हम लोग स्पंज के ऊपर भी इफेक्ट दे सकते हैं। उसके लिए आई विल बी यूजिंग अनदर स्पंज। उसके लिए आपको वापस से फ्रेश वन ही लेना है ऐसे, और मैं ये गोल्ड एंटीक गोल्ड आप ले लो। आपको येलो वाला गोल्ड पसंद है तो आप डेफिनेटली ले सकते हो। एंड आई एम जस्ट गिविंग द इफेक्ट ऑन टॉप ऑफ दिस। ये देखिए जहां जहां पे मुझे रेज डिफेक्ट चाहिए था, जिधर कलर वो आना चाहिए, वो उन चीजों पे मैंने प्रेस कर दिया है, सो ये कलर हो गया. नाउ वी विल टेक द ड्राई ब्रश एंड विल टेक द कलर. जस्ट एक्सेस कलर जो होगा ब्रश में उसको निकाल दीजिए, ज्यादा कलर नहीं लेना है. और बीच बीच में हम लोग जस्ट विल गिव द स्ट्रोक्स ऑफ एंटीक गोल्ड. इफ यू वॉन्ट यू कैन गिव द प्रोमिनेंट गोल्ड, जो थोड़ा ज्यादा शाइनी होता है वो भी आप यूज कर सकते हो. सो आई एम यूजिंग एंटीक गोल्ड हियर बिकॉज मेरा कॉपर के साथ में है, तो एंटीक गोल्ड ही ज्यादा बैलेंस करेगा. बट आप इस तरह से आप पूरा इसको कवर करोगे, यू कैन सी द इफेक्ट. इसमें हमने ब्रॉन्ज और कॉपर के अलावा और कोई यूज नहीं किया है. आप चाहे एंटीक गोल्ड मैंने थोड़ा सा ये सिर्फ बीच बीच में लगाया है. So this way you can create the effect.
Beautiful, it's beautiful.
अगर एकदम sober आपको चाहिए तो मैंने पहले बताया था ये एक जो box जिसमें मैंने दोनों sides पे सिर्फ जो beads थे वो simply चिपकाए हैं. Finger tip से मैंने उसके ऊपर सिर्फ dab किया ये वाले इस पे, और ये जो finger पे पूरा जो finger से ही मैंने dab किया. और यहाँ पे मैंने ब्रश से ड्राई स्ट्रोक्स दिए, बीच बीच में थोड़ा सा व्हाइट ले लिया. इसके अंदर मैंने क्या किया था, व्हाइट कलर दिया था जैसे हमने बॉक्स पे किया, व्हाइट कलर पूरा दिया. जो भी चीजें चिपकानी थी वो चिपकाई. ये जस्ट मिडल पोर्शन जो आपको दिख रहा है, ये रोज के ऊपर का जो उठा हुआ दिख रहा है पोर्शन, यहाँ पे ये जो एरिया, ये सारा टिश्यू पेपर है. सो टिश्यू पेपर को सिंपली क्रम्पल करके मैंने लगा दिया, तो उसकी वजह से ये इफेक्ट आया है. सो आई सेड नो इट्स अ, आप दो लोगों ने देखा अब तक मैंने जो भी चीजें इस्तेमाल की वो सारी जो पुरानी जो घर में पड़ी थी बटन्स मैं लेके बैठी थी, बट आई टोटली फॉरगॉट. बट वो भी आप चिपका सकते हो. जब आप बटन्स चिपकाओगे और फिर उसके ऊपर जब आप हाईलाइट करते हो किसी भी रंग से, तो इट बहुत सुंदर दिखते हैं वो भी. जैसे मेरे पास और एक ये वो जैसा भी था, बट मुझे लगा कि वो थीम से हटके हो रहा है कुछ, सो आई डिड नॉट वॉन्ट टू डू. सो एक मुझे एंटीक इफेक्ट बताना था जो मैंने ब्रॉन्ज और कॉपर के साथ बताया है आपको, और एक आपको जो हमारा अभी ये ऑलमोस्ट सूख गया है. सी दिस. सो आई होप यू लाइक द आर्टिकल्स, बोथ द आर्टिकल्स, एक ब्लैक बैकग्राउंड के साथ में और एक व्हाइट बैकग्राउंड के साथ. So please students try this out. Take your own choice ki combination aap le sakte ho jo aapko color. Mera till blue, all all shades of blue I love the most. Aur bahut acha lagta hai mujhe blue colors ke saath mein, to main pagal ho jati hu. So even you can try your own combination, make your article. Abhi isko bhi main thoda sa lace ko jo humne kiya tha usko main thoda upar se डैप करूंगी, ताकि जो लेस का मेरा आउटलाइन है वो थोड़ा हाईलाइट होगा. ज्यादा नहीं कर रही हूँ मैं, बिकॉज आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू स्पॉइल इट अननेसेसरी. इतना ही सुंदर दिख रहा है. सो इस तरह से आप अपना आर्टिकल बनाइए और आप पोस्ट कीजिए, एंड देन जस्ट गिव मी योर फीडबैक. और वन सेकेंड, मैं अपने पे कैमरा सेट कर देती हूँ. या ओके, सो आई होप जो मैंने आज बताया इट्स एक्चुअली बेस्ट में से बेस्ट बना है. सो आप भी यू कैन ट्राई इट आउट. मिक्स मीडिया यू कैन डू इट ऑन कैनवस, यू कैन डू इट ऑन बॉक्स इफ यू वॉन्ट, यू कैन डू इट ऑन ग्लास, यू कैन मेक योर नेम प्लेट. दैट इज द बेस्ट पार्ट. जैसे अभी ये हमने जो किया, तो वैसे अगर आप बोर्ड पे कर रहे हो चारों तरफ ऐसे लगा के, and you get in the market you get the ready made alphabets. So just simply write down your surname in the center aur usko aap bold se thoda highlight kar dijiye. So ek bahut sa badhiya abhi to aam ki petiyan mil rahi hai, so you can use that the wood platter or rather the wooden planks, you can use it as a base. Uske upar aap charo taraf se aise sari cheeze laga ke आप उसके ऊपर बीच में अगर आप अल्फाबेट्स लगा के चिपका के उसको पेंट कर सकते हो तो भी ठीक है। अगर आप डायरेक्टली पेंट करके उसमें कलर से फिल करते हो अल्फाबेट्स को तो भी यू कैन मेक योर नेम प्लेट ऑल्सो। सो इस तरह से आप डेफिनेटली बनाइए और हमारे ग्रुप पे डालिए। आज के जो भी आप पोस्ट करोगे इमेजेस उसमें आप लिखोगे #FeviCrylMixMediaArticle या मिक्स मीडिया इतना ही लिखोगे तो भी बढ़िया। जस्ट मेक योर ओन डिफरेंट डिफरेंट यू नो क्रिएटिव आइडियाज यूज देम एंड मेक ब्यूटीफुल आर्टिकल ऑफ मिक्स मीडिया एंड पोस्ट इट ऑन द ग्रुप। मैंने लास्ट इसमें से काफी दो तीन जनों ने जो डाले हैं पोस्ट दे हैव बेस्ट वेरी वेल दे हैव ट्राइड उसमें कुछ इतने अच्छे से आए हैं कि आई वॉज लिटरली थिंकिंग कि अगर इन्होंने एक बार में ट्राई करके इतना बढ़िया किया है तो थोड़ा और प्रैक्टिस करेंगे सो यू कैन बी एक्सपर्ट। सो दैट सेम वे ऑफकोर्स आर्ट ही ऐसी चीज है कि एक टाइम करने से पेट नहीं भरता है। यू हैव टू कंटिन्यूअसली डू इट। You have to, you know, while working, you will make the mistake. But usi mistake se you will come to know ki agar brush galti se is taraf us taraf ghum gaya to kya banta hai. So every time, whenever you are na error, trial and error method jaisa hai, just try it out and learn it and you will get good results, beautiful results. So that
way. Ma'am, there's a question. There are a few questions. One is, how do you preserve these articles?
No need to, like, see, suppose now that these are three, now you have to wait till it complete dry. Jaise after say 2 to 3 days it will take to dry because where we have done the texturing part, now because of monsoon it will be, you know, moist. So in from inside it will take time to dry completely. So approximately 2 to 3 days after drying this, what you have to, you get picture varnish or you get the translucent varnish that you will get at hardware store. So apply that one coat or else you have decoupage glue at your place. If you have tried decoupage articles and later on if you have tried, so same decoupage glue you can apply everywhere. So what will happen, you will get one laminated complete coating. So let it dry. Then again you can apply next day second coat, so it will be waterproof and it will get concealed laminated. So either decoupage glue you can apply everywhere on the box or else you can apply varnish, picture varnish or normal varnish, you Asian Paint varnish or there are paint companies varnish, you will get it in the market, those you can use it. Apply two coats. First coat you have to apply, then let it dry for 24 hours, then apply second coat. If you are applying decoupage glue or Fevicryl, you have to apply one coat, let it dry under the fan, say for 4 to 5 hours. Then after 5 hours, apply the second coat, let it dry again for 5 hours. So that means you have to apply 2 to 3 coats. So then it will, you can preserve it, you can wipe with a wet cloth, you can clean with dry brush, no problem. It will stay as it is. Any other question anyone wants to ask?
Some of them are asking about, can you give them a few suggestions for color combinations? Because I think that green and blue that you've used is fantastic. It's awesome. It's really nice. With a little bit of mauve on the sides, I guess they're asking for more. And Yatin sir wants you to quote a little bit about Fevicryl Mod Podge.
Okay, that is what I said for the top coat. What I am saying about decoupage glue, that is Mod Podge only. Mod Podge you can always use to conceal your article, to conceal, to give the lamination coat. Any article, any like normal painting also, if you want to, you know, preserve without framing, you just apply 2 to 3 layers of Mod Podge. Fevicryl Mod Podge, it will stay as it is because it will get completely laminated.
It will give a lovely shine, a sheen on your article.
If you don't want shine for that also, I will give one tip in free of cost. Sorry. That is like, suppose if I don't like very glossy effect on top, what you have to do, apply the decoupage glue and immediately dab with dry sponge. So you will have the matte effect. So if you don't want the glossy effect, you can just apply the Mod Podge and then dab it with a dry sponge. So you will have the simple matte effect. And another thing you asked about the combination, color combination. See, always whenever you are planning for your article, there are two types of color scheme. One is warm color scheme and one is cool color scheme, which I followed here. That is cool color scheme. Cool color scheme, which, you know, all shades of blue, all shades of purple, all shades of little bit of green. Those are all cool colors. You know, those are soothing. You know, you get the soothing or very cool and, you know, calm effect with cool colors. So whenever you want that calm effect or brightness or freshness, you should go for all shades of blue and green, and you can add more white in it.
Warm colors
includes yellow, orange, red, and you can add up little bit of you know, brown also in it. So those are the earthy colors. Those are warm colors. It gives the fire, the energy. So if you are making something you know, like rocky or something like a forest theme, then definitely you can go with those colors. You cannot mix green and red together, because it will make your article very, very dull, because brown and orange and green, that combination is always makes very dull colors. Because of that, your project will look dull. So always try to highlight with gold, or if it is cool color, try to highlight with silver. So that is the, I gave you the tip, like you can sprinkle the glitter. It was in my mind, but at present it is not handy. But I will definitely put it on this, and I will click the picture, and I will be sending you on the group. So
thank you so much, ma'am. There are two more questions. One is, how expensive are the stencil sheets, and does Pidilite Industries, do they manufacture or sell stencils?
Yes, definitely we do sell. But I did not like to get up again and again from my place. But I will be posting few stencils images. We are definitely having, Pidilite is having so many stencils designed, all animal prints, floral prints, geometrical prints. And the it starts from 15 rupees to 100 rupees. It depends on which brand you are buying.
Somebody said that it's expensive. That's not expensive at all. It seems stencils come for 25 rupees each. That is what Yatin sir has written in the title.
I know there is one design, animal prints. In that, we are having leopard print, chitta print. Then we are having zebra print. I think so one giraffe print is also there. There's four design combination, which was, I bought it in 100 rupees. So that was big design sheet. But we do have small designs also. And these are not at all expensive. It is starts from 15 rupees till in 100, you will get all the designs.
Okay.
And I'm having lot many designs. I will definitely click the pictures and I will be sending you. So Fevicryl designs, rose design, it was there with me. Now I don't know where I kept it.
It's okay, ma'am. We've got an idea.
Yeah.
One more thing is, before telling you what Yatin sir has said, there's one from the participant. She says, how can we get matte finish with the Fevicryl acrylic colors, especially for base when we require?
Acrylic colors are matte colors.
Are matte colors, correct.
Acrylic, you know, we are having Fevicryl is a brand. And in Fevicryl, under that brand, we are having normal colors, that is we call classic shades. This classic shades means the normal without any shine. So what set I showed you of this 10 color ka, that is classic shades. So these are all classic shades. So these are matte shades, like all, if you are mixing with white and black is there, but all are not shiny. It will give you matte effect colors. Then we are having shimmery colors. That is, you will have little glittery kind of touch in that particular colors. Then we are having pearl colors, which are all pastel light shades, but they will have the some simple, sober satin shine. So like a satin material. So pearl colors we are having. We are having metallic colors, which comes gold, silver, bronze, and copper. Copper and bronze, I have used it today. Antique gold also we are having, which is literally shimmery color, but it looks very vibrant, which was not there with me today. Otherwise, I could have really sent you the, I could have showed you. But we are having all different ranges. See, when you are going in the market or when you are asking for the color, first you ask for pedalite shade card. We are having glitter colors, shimmery colors, pearl colors, and classic shades. Classic shades are all matte shades, normal. We are having a new range with the pastel shades also. The lovely colors, till blue, greenery, then there is a salmon pink, then there is a coral red, which colors are really attractive, which if you are using those colors, only two colors if you are using greenery and till blue. It's absolutely matte and very sober colors. You tried them out. That is why I will always advise, whenever you are going to buy any colors in the market, first you ask them, give us the shade card. On shade card, they will be. You will get the idea, so many range. Every more than 200 or 300 shades are there of pedalite. So you will really get confused which color to buy, which color not to buy. So
Yatin sir says, can you please show the different mask you have painted?
Yeah, I will be showing you that.
You have to get up for that because we can plan a mask painting workshop next.
Okay, 1 minute. Yeah, wow, because of that, I got the pedalite stencil also in this. So this kind of stencils we are getting of pedalite. You can see the pedalite name over here, Fevicryl. Okay, so see, this is three different designs. So this kind of stencils you are getting small designs, big designs. So you can go in the market and ask for Fevicryl stencils ready. And this is one time if you are buying. I'm having lot many designs. I think so. I'm working since so long. So from the beginning, whatever stencil designs were there, all are there with me. So I will be sending you a few images if you want to go in the market and buy. So now first I will be showing you the mask, what we are planning next. This is my basket. We have a lot different types of mask. Yesterday only I tried one. See, this is one which I made it with stencil effect. You can see on the sides. So with embroidery effect, I will be showing you. This here I have used the stencils of pedalite as well as the 3D outliners. Then this mask I have done only with 3D outliners. I have given the embroidery effect in this. I will be showing you. I hope it is visible clearly. Okay, so here I have used the embroidery effect. Here I have used few pearls with 3D outliner. I have made a totally different designing. This is opening like this. So if we are planning for this particular session, we are having approximately four different types of masks I will be teaching you. This is with the printed material. We have done a little bit of painting on top of that. So this is the mask, and it is really a lovely, very
thank
interesting.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Yeah, very nice, lovely.
One scarf mask, which is I have planned it. Here we are not just wearing simple mask, because I know all the girls, they don't like just to wear the mask. It is like a scarf, which we can plan it for our workshop. Here, with the mask, I have made a big, huge scarf. So how you can wear this? simply you can take the upper side, just tie it, and we'll cover this scarf. I have done dabu printing on top of that. It was plain white cloth, and on that I have given the dabu printing. And this two area we are going to tie around your neck. You can put this way. So if you want to wear, the whole mask will look like a scarf. So this is nowadays it's in the trend, and plus you can just cover it here from inside. You can make it a little smaller if you want, like a scarf. You can just tuck it here inside like this. So your scarf is ready with the mask. So no one can make out that you have worn the mask, but it is actually mask with the scarf. So this is lovely. I thought I should not make typical mask, so I made it this kind of mask where you can use your old dupattas, you can use your old scarves too.
Okay, ma'am. That was all the questions that are there, and because some of them are repeating the same thing about how do you make textures with palette or not. So can we have Ashwini? Because I thought those party masks, that that's why I was like looking out for those painted masks. Can we have Ashwini taking over?
We can go for a party mask. That is how we are wearing, in party with the stick we are taking. Yeah. But the same kind of mask of different design, like a butterfly.
Really nice, lovely.
So whatever, ma'am, you say, you just give me.
Lovely. I know the ideas will flow out. Lovely, yeah. Lovely.
Thank you, ma'am. I hope all the students and all the teachers have enjoyed this today's session. Please try out this different texturing on mixed media, and you can just post it.
Sure.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, Ashwini.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for today's session. Definitely, we have learned that waste isn't waste until we waste it. So this was a really lovely session and we all really enjoyed it. Now, please request our youngest faculty member, Ms. Sakina Tinwala, ma'am, to propose a word of thanks to all the participants who have been registered to us. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, Ashwini. On behalf of all the participants in our department, I would like to thank you, Aparna ma'am, for so beautifully demonstrating this artistic workshop. You make everything look so easy that just watching you work motivates us to grab our brushes. And after today's workshop, we all will surely look at our waste from a creative perspective. The image merging technique, antique effect, the stenciling effect were all so wonderful. We all thank you for removing your time and training us on various techniques, tips and methods that we can use. I would also like to thank Mr. Yatin Negandhi, the marketing head of Pidilite, for coordinating this workshop between Pidilite and our college. Thank you, dear participants, for attending. You all are the heart of this webinar. Thank you all and have a pleasant day.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Mr. Yatin, by when should they submit their artwork to get the certificate from Pidilite? We will be giving it to them as participating in the workshop. But when they submit their artwork, by when? What is the deadline for submitting their artwork?
I think so. I will answer for that. We will be giving you 3 days. Now, I think so. Today is Wednesday.
Today is Friday.
So, give them 1 week time. 3 days is too less because many of them are running around for materials and things like that, especially.
Okay, ma'am. No problem. For 3 to 4 days, is it okay for you? 4 days?
Ma'am, by next Saturday, can we tell them? Is it okay? By next Saturday, and that would be 20th. Because we have given them time till 15th for one stroke. We can add maybe. Till 20th for submitting the articles of mixed media.
No problem. So everyone can take till Saturday 12 o'clock you can post your article.
And they have to write hashtag Fevicryl, hashtag mixed media.
Post hashtag Fevicryl, mixed media.
Fevicryl, Hashtag?
Hashtag mixed media.
Mixed media. Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.